one of the trends that we've been seeing, and this is driven by the REITs, I think you have to take, you can't really take those two sides independently. You kind of have to mash them together because of the way the REITs are playing ball now. So they're changing the dynamics of the game as we speak. We've seen this happening. They're introducing those teaser rates. They're bringing in very low street rates. We've seen downward pressure on street rates. We're seeing them fall. But what's happening is the REITs, because they have so many more properties and they have a much better information base, they're able to track the existing tenant, the normalization rates. There are no data sources that are really tracking that. They have a hard time keeping track of that. But if you're Extra Space or Public Storage, you have this massive database to work with. So what we're seeing is those street rates are getting dropped, and then the REITs are pushing those rates up on a month-to-month basis with the existing tenants. And so as an independent operator, if you have it managed by, you know, Life Storage, Extra Space, or one of the big ones, then you're tapping into that knowledge and that data set that they have. If you're working as a true independent, you have a much harder time tracking with those actual normalization of existing tenant rates. So you can play the game where you drop those rates down, but you're operating a little bit more in the dark in terms of raising rates over time. And it's a little bit more trial and error, and it's a little riskier than, say, one of the big REITs. So rates are going to be the battlefield in 2024. And the independents, quite frankly, are at a little bit of a disadvantage here. And they just don't have the same access to data. So they're going to have to work with their tenants and see where that normalization is on the longer term sustained tenant rates.